What we're going to talk about is radical, or radical sine. The area of a square with sine s is represented by s squared. Let me draw this first. The sine is s, and of course, being a square, all the sides are equal. The area is s squared, or s times itself. Now, I'm going to introduce something here. This symbol is called the radical sign. The radical of A is s. We refer to s as being the root of the area. Okay, so let me show you this. Let me use a symbol, let's call it x, okay? This is called the radical sign. Radical sign. When it's only square, when the power is 2, we don't have to put a number here, but usually there's a number, and this number is called an index. And what is under the radical, or inside this sign, is called a radicand. So these are a bunch of names that people refer to in terms of the radical sign. So let me give you another example. Let's talk about cube. Here's a cube whose size are s, and the depth is also s. All right, the volume of a cube is s raised to the third power, or s cubed. Now the root of the volume because the exponent here, this exponent becomes the index. You want to say the cube root of v is equal to s, and s is the cube root of v.